Hi students, in this video we will discuss about sound. In our last video we discussed about metals and non-metals. So in this video we will discuss about sound. It was the next lesson in your textbook. So first you have to know the definition of sound. So what is sound? A sound is a form of energy that is produced when air molecules vibrate in a particular pattern called waves. Hence the sound is a wave. That means sound, it is one type of energy. How it will be produced? That is produced when air molecules vibrate in a particular pattern. For example, now I was here and the student is there. So when I am talking here, the air molecules, what are the air molecules between us? So that air molecules, it will vibrate. So when it will vibrate, those air molecules reach to your ear. So you can listen my words by vibration of those air molecules in a particular pattern. So we can say sound, it is one type of wave. So here, depending upon the vibrations, a sound is produced. Means this sound, it will be depending on that type of vibrations. Sometimes if the vibrations frequency is very high, then you will listen high voice. If the vibration frequency is very less, then you will listen low sound. So like that, the sound, it will be depending on that type of vibrations. Sound cannot be produced without any vibration. So sound, it will be never formed without any vibration. So if sound is there should be vibration. I said here some examples. One is drum. When we hit the drum, membrane of drum vibrate, produce a sound. So when we hit that drums, so that drums, it will vibrates. Because of those vibrates, we will listen the sound of that drum. And another one is a guitar. When we play guitar, the string on it makes to and fro motion and produce sound. So when we play this guitar, this guitar having one string, so this string, it will move to and fro vibrations. Because of those vibrations, the guitar sound we can listen. And another one is turning fork. So sound produced by vibration, this is also producing sound because of vibrations. So these are the some examples which are depending on the vibrating. Now see, propagation of sound through a medium. Sound always requires a medium to travel from the source of its production to the receiver end. That means, for example, now I am here, production. So you are listening my words, means you are receiver. So I am here, production, and you are receiver. So if you want to listen my words, you are able to listen my words, means our between us one medium is there. Because of that medium, you are listening my words. So here, what is that medium that you have to know? So here, different mediums of propagation of sound are there. Those are air, liquid, and solid. In these three, the sound, it will be moved. So if sound want to move from one place to another place, there compulsory these three mediums, in these three any one medium should be there. So those are air, liquid, and solid. For example, now I am talking here, you are listening my words, means our between us air medium is there, so that you are listening my words. So medium is compulsory to pass that sound. So sound cannot travel through a vacuum, as it lacks any medium of transmission. So sound cannot travel. So sound never travel if in vacuum. So if there is vacuum, then sound, it can't move from one place to another place. Sound, it is moving, means there compulsory medium is there. That medium may be air, liquid, or solid. So previously I said about if sound is propagated, means there should be medium is there. So now your doubt, how the sound will be propagated in the medium? So what are the mediums? I said air, liquid, and gas. So how sound will be propagated in these three mediums, that we will discuss here. So here sound needs some vibrations of molecules to travel. This I already told previously. So if sound is moving means there should be vibrated molecules. So if vibrated molecules are there, because of that vibration the sound is moving from one place to another place, that we already discussed. So solids, liquids and gases all have molecules present in them which allows the propagation of sound. So solids, liquids and gases, these three are having those vibrated molecules, so that the sound, it is moving from one place to another place in air, gas and liquids, because these three mediums are having these vibrated molecules, that's why the sound it can move. So these molecules are particles in solids, liquids and gases are packed in varied ways. That means these vibrated molecules, these will be present in those mediums in the different ways. In the solid it will be in different way, in liquids it will be different way, those vibrated molecules, in air it will be different way, those vibrated molecules. So now you understood the vibrated molecules present in air, gas, liquids, that's why in these three mediums the sound is moving from production to receiver. So solids have tightly packed particles in them and hence they allow fast propagation of sound. So tightly packed particles are there where in solids medium. So the particles, those particles in the solid, it will be very tightly packed. So tightly packed means the molecules, it will be present like this, there is no gap. So if production is there, if production, if who, the person who is talking, he will be here, the person who is listening, he will be here. So when he is talking, there is no gap between the molecules, the sound it will go very fastly in the solid medium. So allows fast propagation of sound through them, as the vibrations can be carried easily from one particle to another particle, because here this is one particle and this is another particle and this one is another particle, so there is no gap. So immediately the sound, first it will be going to this molecule and after that this molecule, immediately they will catch that vibrated molecules. So immediately the sound it will go very fastly through solid medium. Liquids have slightly loosely packed particles and hence it takes a little time for sound to travel in water or through a liquid. That means we previously discussed solids, in the solids the particles, the molecules are tightly packed, so the sound it will move very fastly. But as per liquids, it packed loosely, the particles it packed loosely, so the movement of that sound it takes little bit less compared with solid. And next one is gases. Gases have completely loosely packed particles. So the gap between the molecules, the gap between the molecules, for example, we previously discussed, for example, solid particles. Solid particles, it will be like this, very tightly it will packed in the solid. But if you come as per liquids, the molecules, it is having little bit gap. So here the person, and here the receiver. So now he is talking, this person is talking, the sound from here to here it takes time, because the molecules distance is the gap it is having, the molecules between it is having gap, so it takes time to reach to receiver. So this is as per liquids. As per gases, the molecules, those are very far. Very far in the gas medium, the molecules will be very far. So the person is here and this person is here. So the sound it is moving from here to here, it takes so much time. So here the sound is moving very fast because the molecules distance is very less and molecules are very tightly packed. So as per liquids, it is having little bit gap, so it take little bit time to reach from one place to another place. But as per gases, the molecules gap is very high, so it take so much time. So gases have completely loosely packed particles and hence sound takes the most time in traveling through the air. So in this video we discussed about sound, how it will be moved from one place to another place. So because of vibrating molecules, because of vibrating molecules the sound it is moving from one place to another place. So these vibrating molecules are present in three mediums, those are air, liquid and gas. In these three mediums these vibrated molecules are there, so that the sound it can travel in air, gas and liquids. So in the solid the particles are very tightly packed, so it can move from one place to another place the sound very fastly. But in the liquids it is having little bit gap, so it will take time. And in the gases the molecules distance is very very far, so it will take too much time the sound moving from one place to another place. So these we discussed in this video. So please follow once your textbook. Thank you.